Sarah, let me start by asking you what the president said about potentially meeting with Vladimir Putin, quote, soon. There's nothing that will put them in the same city at the same time until November at the earliest. So what he's talking about in terms of soon, would that include either a visit of Putin to the White House or the president going to Russia?
There are no specific plans made at this time, but we want to continue to have a dialogue with Russia and continue to talk about some of the shared interests we have, whether it's North Korea, Iran, and particularly, as the president noted today, slowing the tensions when it comes to an arms race, something that is clearly important to both leaders.
And now that Putin has won yet another term as president, is President Trump concerned that he will continue his aggressive posture toward the rest of the world and maybe even increase that posture?
Look, we're going to continue to maintain the position that we've had and be tough when necessary. At the same time, we want to continue to have dialogue so that we can work on some of the issues that concern both countries. And we're going to continue to do that while also continuing to be tough on a number of things, including sanctions on Russia, rebuilding our own military, and exporting energy, things that we know are not great for Russia. Major.
Get your reaction to a statement that Senator John McCain, the chairman of the Armed Services Committee, just put out, and I'm quoting him directly here. An American president does not lead the free world by congratulating dictators on winning sham elections. And by doing so with Vladimir Putin, President Trump insulted every Russian citizen who was denied the right to vote in a free and fair election to determine their country's future, including the countless Russian patriots who have risked so much protest and resist Putin's regime. How do you respond?
Look, the president once again has maintained that it's important for us to have a dialogue with Russia so that we can focus on some areas of shared interest, the ones that I've already named. At the same time, we're going to continue to be tough on them. The president joined other countries in these calls. Both Germany and France have reached out, as well as President Obama in 2012. These are conversations that sometimes take place, and certainly the president finds there to be an importance in having that dialogue with Russia so that we can talk about some of the big problems that face the world.
Does the White House disagree with Senator McCain's characterization of this as a sham election?
We disagree with the fact that we shouldn't have conversations with Russia. There are important topics that we should be able to discuss, and that is why the president's going to continue to have that dialogue. At the same time, we've been very clear in the actions that we've taken that we're going to be tough on Russia, particularly when it comes to areas that we feel where they've stepped out of place. We've placed tough sanctions on Russia and a number of other things where we have shown exactly what our position is.
You brought up in context of John's question about timing, since you mentioned North Korea and Iran, is it the president's intention to meet with Vladimir Putin before he sees Kim Jong-un or makes a decision on the Iran nuclear deal?
Again, we don't have any specific plans laid out at this time.
Sarah, thanks, Sarah. But neither the White House readout of that phone call with Putin nor the Kremlin's readout says anything about election meddling. Did the president not raise the issue of Russian election meddling in that phone call?
I don't believe it came up on this specific call, but it is something that we've spoken extensively about and continue to look at ways and steps forward to make sure it never happens again.
And on the president's new attorney, Joe DiGenova, he says that there is this brazen plot by the FBI and the DOJ to frame the president. Does the White House share that view? Is there a plot to frame President Trump?
Look, we certainly have said that there have been some concerns with some of the actions that were taken, but in terms of any comments that he's made, I couldn't speak to those. Matthew.
Thanks, Sarah. Two more questions on the Putin phone call. First, does the White House believe the election in Russia was free and fair?
I'm sorry?
Does the White House believe that the election in Russia was free and fair?
Look, in terms of the election, there we're focused on our elections. We don't get to dictate how other countries operate. What we do know is that Putin has been elected in their country, and that's not something that we can dictate to them how they operate. We can only focus on the freeness and the fairness of our election, something we 100% fully support, and something we're going to continue to do everything we can to protect, to make sure bad actors don't have the opportunity to impact them in any way.
And you said election meddling didn't come up in the call. I'm curious, did the recent poisoning in the United Kingdom come up in the call?
I don't believe that was discussed in today's call.